You might not think you can get away with a whole lot of hillshade weirdness in ArcGIS Online in a browser. But maybe you can get away with some weirdness. Effects and blend modes are a pathway to abilities that some consider to be unnatural. We're going to start with the already gorgeous World Hillshade and then do stuff to make mountain ranges pop. Here I am in ArcGIS Online. Let's look at this base map. I want a different base map, something earthy. And I'll search Living Atlas for khaki. And I'll choose this khaki map as my base map. Done. Now in my layers, I'm going to add, also from Living Atlas, Hillshade. And I'm going to add in this World Hillshade global tile layer managed by Rajinder Nagi, and it's beautiful. Seriously, look at this. The texture, the terrain, it's insane. I love it. But there's always weird things we can push and pull in our maps to make it our own. I'd like to add a little bit more of a visual focus to the overall structure of these mountain ranges and not just the detail of the mountains themselves. Does that make sense? So I'm gonna add this a second time. So now I have two World Hillshades here, and I'm gonna open the effects and choose blur. I get a blur of about 6 or so. I've fuzzed my eyes, so now I can see the mountain ranges and not so much detail. And I'll blend this blurry version into the crisp version. And I'll use a blend mode called color burn. Here's the difference. With, without, with, without. We're getting a little bit more of that blurry overall shade on the right side of these mountain ranges. But by blending these two hillshades, it's a little bit darker than I would want. How do I lighten this while keeping the dark shaded side of my mountain ranges? How do I lighten the left side of these mountain ranges? I'm gonna add another one. I'll give this the same blur of 6. And now I'm going to activate the brightness and contrast options. For the brightness, I can come down, let's say 55, and I'll push this contrast all the way up. And now I'm going to use the lightness of any of these pixels to erase the hillshade underneath. Here's how. Back in the properties, I'm going to use the blend mode of screen. Screen takes the lightness of any pixels and discards the darkness. So now I've kind of returned some lightness to the sun-facing side of these mountain ranges, and I've maintained the darker shadows on the right side. And I'm benefiting from a little bit of that blurry overall shadow that you see in real life. And lastly, I want to put all of these three together into a group and use the multiply blend mode so that I can see through to my underlying base map. Now with this group selected, I'll give it a blend mode of multiply. Multiply will only bake in the darker tones into the underlying base map. This is the layer that lightened the sun-facing sides. This is the layer that casts a little bit more blurriness. This is the original crisp layer. Crisp, fuzzy shadow, fuzzy highlights. And you can play with this effect for the lightning layer's brightness and contrast. Check it out. Brightness and contrast to taste. Whatever looks best to you. is best. Feel free to play around with all of these settings. And keep on turning things on and off to compare what you started with to what you ended with. And you've got yourself a pseudo ambient illusion effect in ArcGIS Online with a couple of effects and some blend modes.